In this three-video mini-series, we're going to discuss MRI versus X-ray. In video one, we'll briefly talk about how each of these modalities works and whether or not they emit harmful radiation. In video two, we'll look at which one is the better choice for analyzing your posture. And finally, in video three, we'll look at some real examples of neck and low back X-rays and MRIs and compare the two. Let's start with MRI, magnetic resonance imaging. An MRI machine is really a gigantic magnet that provides 3D images. It's like being placed in the middle of a massive donut. You don't really need to know how it works, but I happen to think it's fascinating. So humans are made of water, and water is made of hydrogen and oxygen, H2O. Hydrogen has a positive charge because if you recall from high school chemistry, it has one proton. When the body is placed in a strong magnetic field, such as an MRI, the protons in each hydrogen atom line up along the same axis. And when the magnetic field is then turned off, after say 20 minutes, the protons flip back again, and this causes a signal. The signal is used to create the image. Pretty cool, right? So because an MRI uses magnets or magnetic radiation, it isn't harmful to our body. X-rays work differently. They also use energy, but not from a magnet. The beam of energy from an X-ray comes into contact with our body and is absorbed in different amounts by different tissues. An X-ray beam passes straight through softer tissue and looks black on the film, but gets absorbed by denser material like bone, and these structures look white on film. X-ray imaging is ionizing radiation. In other words, it delivers much more energy into the body than an MRI. This high-frequency energy causes atoms or molecules to gain or lose electrons, and this can damage a cell. Now, damaged cells divide and create more damaged cells. That's why we don't X-ray pregnant women, because there's a lot of cell division happening there. Before we freak out about having an X-ray, let's put it into perspective. There are many items we use every day that emit low-dose radiation. Sunlight, cell phones, tablets, computers, Wi-Fi routers, microwaves, cigarettes, television, and fertilizers. It's the cumulative effect of yearly radiation that's important here. In Canada, the Nuclear Safety Commission sets a limit of 50 millisieverts of maximum allowable radiation in 1 year, and 100 over 5 years, or an average of 20 millisieverts per year. Take a look at this chart, broken down into region of the body, total radiation dose in millisieverts, and any increased risk of cancer from that dose. So our natural background radiation every year from household objects is 3.1 per year. A bone scan, 0.001. Now pilots, they get about 2.2 millisieverts per year, and the average American receives 6.2 millisieverts a year. Now you can take a look at the whole chart, but I highlighted two that I wanted you to see. I send a lot of my students and patients for neck X-rays, which is a standard two views. That's only 0.2 millisieverts of radiation, considered 0% increase in cancer risk. Compare that to a 7-hour flight. That's like me flying from Toronto to London, England. Also 0.02. Perspective is what's important here. The benefit from having a structural diagnosis provided by an X-ray far outweighs the risk of harmful radiation. So in video two in this three-part series, we're going to discuss what imaging modality, X-ray or MRI, is the gold standard for analyzing your posture and spinal alignment. Make sure you're subscribed so you don't miss the next video. And if you like this topic, please give a thumbs up. And go ahead and take our free posture test and see how well you're doing.